We're at the Women's Peace and Humanitarian Fund conference, although the conference is called something different.
It's the Global Women's Forum for Peace and Humanitarian Action.
Yes, that's what it's called. And I'm sitting here with Corinne and Matthew, who do all of the work.
Yeah.
Who do all of the work.
No.
Yeah, huh? Mm-hmm.
I mean, other than the women who are actually making the change, they organize everything, and they deserve a little credit. And Corinne, where are you from? Michigan?
I'm from Michigan.
Yeah, baby.
I'm from Texas.
Texas, yeah. And now you live in New York?
New York, yes. New York
and City. You used to live in Michigan?
Yes, and I live in Washington Township.
And how often do you travel for this job?
About every other month.
Every other month. And you have two kids?
Three kids.
Yeah. Corinne, that's one too many.
Yeah.
You don't have any kids yet, do you?
No kids. No, me and my husband. We want kids someday, maybe.
Maybe.
We're still, you know, considering our options.
But you're very busy right now.
Yes, a little busy.
And I just wanted to, you know, shine a light on the people who actually do the work.
It's not just us, we promise.
Yeah, there's tons
so
of people all over the world doing the work.
That's true, all over the world, and we're connected and given these women, because the whole point of the Women's Peace and Humanitarian Fund is that they empower, see, Monica thinks she's a real real jokester. Look at Monica's sweatshirt.
Yes.
Look at you can't. It's probably backwards.
It's backwards, but it says "Every day I'm hustling."
Okay.
Every day I'm hustling, and mine says "Empowered women empower women."
Love it.
And that is the truth.
It because should be the tagline of our conference, I think.
It should, right?
It really should.
Because this fund it gives women write grants to solve their local problems, mm-hmm. whether it's mediation or economic resources that they need, and they get funding. And here's the cool thing. If they don't receive the grant, someone still contacts them, right, about mm-hmm. how to write a better grant, how they could improve.
We're building up their capacity so that they can be stronger and help their communities grow and prosper and build a more stable and peaceful society.
Yeah, because the reality is there's a statistic I heard today that women, if they are at the leadership table making decisions for peace, that peace has a 30%, 35% more likelihood of lasting 15 years or longer.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just science. So it's inarguable.
Facts.
But there's, yeah, women who are funded in trauma counseling, in like economic opportunities, like they'll open a bakery or agriculture, also mediation to talk to all the dudes in their neighborhood to be like, stop fighting, we don't need to fight. You know, that's just dumbing it down a ton, but I just wanted to show you the people behind the scenes, my friends.